Welcome to My Zone Online School. My name is Teacher Mutsa. Get your education booklet in our daily newspaper, street sales, or at your school every Monday to Thursday for pre-primary up until grade 3. The lessons are for listening or watching online. Inside the newspapers, there is an insert of the lesson booklet. Please cut the top of the lesson booklet with a pair of scissors and fold it for ready to use. But there is more. We are also available on our online platforms, MyZone and Zoshi Facebook pages, and in addition, our website, Zoshi Online. Hello everyone and welcome to My Zone Online School. My name is Teacher Mutsa and thank you so much for joining me today. Our theme this week is My Family. And before we get into any lessons, boys and girls, we need to sanitize. So please take your sanitizer, put a little bit in your hand, and let us sing our special song. Sanitize every day so the germs can stay away. Sanitize every day so the germs can stay away. Yay! Good job, everyone! For today's lesson, we will be talking about preposition, mass, and sequencing. For our lesson now, boys and girls, let us turn to page 5. On page 5, we are going to be doing a little exercise about this little boy. You can see how many boys? 1, 2. 2 little boys. Now, what we are going to do with this little boy is that we are going to cut him out and we are going to paste him on the bed and under the table. So, we are going to be using a pair of scissors and some glue as well. Now, boys and girls, you must remember that a pair of scissors can be very, very dangerous. So, if you are going to use a pair of scissors, please make sure that you have an adult with you. And then when you are done using your pair of scissors, make sure that you put it away. It is not a toy. So after you are done cutting out your two boys, just like how I have cut out my two boys, you are going to paste them correctly. So the first boy we have to paste on the bed. Here is our bed, and as you can see, it's big enough for our boy so that we can paste him. So I'm going to put our boy on the bed. And if I put him on the bed, then he will be standing on the bed. Then the next boy, I am going to put him under the table. This is the table, the brown that you can see on or in your booklet. So we are going to paste him underneath the table. So I'm going to take my boy and paste him underneath the table. And now my work is complete. Make sure that when you are cutting, try and cut straight lines. But if you're not able to, that's okay. You can ask the adult that is with you to help you cut. So long you end up pasting your boy by yourself. Now that we are done with this page together, let's quickly go to the next page, page 7. On page 7, we are going to be doing some massive measurements. Now, as you can see, we are going to be comparing the three things that we have there. We have a sack of flour, a container of rice, and a packet of sugar. So the first one is flour. Point to the flour. Very good. Then we have rice. Well done. And then we have sugar. Now each of these things weigh differently. So we are having a big job to color the heaviest with a red crayon. And then after that, we are going to color the lightest with a yellow crayon. So that means we're going to use two types of crayons. We have red and yellow. So let us take a look at the board to check which ones are our red ones and our big ones or the heaviest one and which one is the lightest. So I have drawn here my flour, rice, and sugar. And each one weighs differently, which means it's heavy in a different way. Now from the picture, you can already see, just like in your book, that the heaviest one must be the flour. And it is your job to color the heaviest one with a red color. So please, when you are coloring your flour, you can either color going from side to side, or you go and color up and down. Make sure if it is side to side, you start going up or going down. And if it is from up, top to bottom, you are starting from one side or from another side, going in one direction. So our red one belongs to the flower. Now we want to find the lightest one. And as you can see, just like in your books, the lightest one is the smallest one, which is the sugar. So we are going to use the yellow color to color the sugar. Again, when you're coloring, it's either you're coloring from side to side or top to bottom. And make sure that when you're done, it's very neat. Take your time with the coloring and please don't color outside the lines. Try and stay inside and make the flour, remember, red, and the sugar, yellow. Now, let us go to our last exercise for this lesson on page 8. On page 8, we have a beautiful girl who seems to be doing activities. The first one, you can see that she is sleeping soundly in her bed. And then you can see her eating a delicious meal. And then after that, you can see that she is reading her books. Now, it is going to be our job to color the pictures of events with different colors. The morning event is going to be blue. The yellow event and the evening is the yellow event is going to be for the afternoon, and for the evening event, you are going to use red. So these are the three colors that you're going to use. Remember, for the morning event, you are going to use a blue color. And then for the afternoon, you are going to be using a yellow color. And then for the evening, you are going to be using the red color. Now, we all do things differently, but if you talk to the adult about what you do in the evening, which is meaning nighttime, in the morning, which means the first thing when you wake up, and in the afternoon, which means somewhere around lunchtime, they'll be able to help you. I think I've already given you some clues on which one is which. So I know that you are clever and you are going to decide which event is in the morning, and the morning one you will use blue. Very good. Then after that, you are going to color the afternoon event, and the afternoon event, you are going to color it yellow. And then the last one, the evening event, when it's night time and we are done with everything, you are going to color that one red. So take your time. You're not allowed to mix the colors, only one color for one picture. And when you are done with all three of your exercises, check that you have done the right thing, and the adult that is with you can help you understand if you're not sure. Take your time, and I will see you soon after the advert break.
Follow us on MyZone Facebook, Active Kids, to watch your daily lesson and other fun activities with Zoe and Zoshi.
We have now come to the end of our lesson, boys and girls, and I hope you had so much fun. I know I had fun with you. Remember, if you're not sure or you don't understand, you can always ask an adult for help. Just make sure you end up doing your work by yourself. So now that we are done with our exercise, let us sanitize. Now remember, when we are sanitizing, we rub inside our hands, in between our fingers, around our hands, very good, on our wrists, and the fingertips too. Make sure your hands are dry before you touch anything else. I wonder though, I have not seen Sashi, and I want us to sing our special goodbye song. Hello, Sashi. So, Sashi, I want us to sing our special goodbye song to our friends. Is that okay? Yay, good. So, before we say goodbye, please remember to stay safe all the time. Are you ready, Sashi? Good. Goodbye, goodbye. It's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. It's time to say goodbye. Bye!
Our online school will help you along the way. Find us at www.zoshi.online and download the booklet. Follow us on Facebook to never miss a video. Subscribe to our Zoshi Telegram channel if you want to receive daily updates. Proudly sponsored by the Ministry of Education, Arts and Culture, Namibian Community Trust, UNICEF, MyZone Online School, Amos Meerkat Syllabus, and Capricorn Foundation.